SAS Studio includes integration with Git, a system for tracking changes and managing version control among multiple users. Git can be used with many different repository hosting services, such as GitHub, GitLab, or Bitbucket. This demonstration will illustrate the process using GitHub. Before you can get started using any of the Git features in SAS Studio, you must first create a Git profile. Navigate to Options, Manage Git Connections. Select Profiles and click the plus sign to add a profile. Notice that by default, SAS Studio uses SSH keys for authentication. You must create and upload your public and private SSH keys to the workspace server and your repository hosting service. Click Cancel and close the Manage Git Connections window for now. And let's first generate the required SSH keys. It's recommended that you use ED25519 SSH keys. These keys can be generated using the PuttyGen key generator or Git Bash with the following command: ssh-keygen-t ED25519-c, and then in quotation marks, your email. This is the same email used in your repository hosting service. You may confirm or change the location to store the key pair, and optionally set a passphrase. I'll press Enter for no passphrase, and press Enter again to confirm. The SSH keys are now saved. The next step is to add the new public key to my repository hosting service. I've logged into GitHub with my personal profile. If you're following along, you'll need to have your own personal profile. Select your account picture from the upper right corner and choose Settings. In the left panel, select SSH and GPG keys. Click New SSH key and type SAS Studio in the title field. In my operating system file manager, I'll navigate to the .ssh folder where keys are stored and open the id_ed25519.pub file in a text editor. Copy the public key text, then return to GitHub and paste the text in the key field. Click Add SSH key. Let's return to SAS Studio. Now we must upload our SSH key pair to the server file system. Create a new folder in a writable location under the server files icon. I'll name it SSH keys. When working in your own environment that can be accessed by other users, make sure that your SSH keys are stored securely. Select the new folder and click Upload. Navigate to the .ssh folder. Select both id_ed25519 files and click Upload. Now we're ready to create a Git profile. Go back to Options, Manage Git Connections, then select Profiles and click the plus sign to add a new profile. Confirm the SSH tab is active and provide a profile name of your choice. I'll type my GitHub. Then enter your commit author email. Navigate to find the public SSH file with the .pub extension that we just uploaded to the server file system. Repeat the process to also select the private SSH key, which doesn't have a file extension. Click OK to create the profile, then click Close. In order to access files from a Git repository in SAS Studio, you must clone the repository. Cloning copies all files from the remote repository to a working directory that you specify on your SAS server file system. Open a new tab in your browser and visit github.com/sas-software/sas-viya-quick-start. You won't have access to modify the files in this repository, but you can create your own copy of the SAS Viya Quick Start repository so that you can make changes and save your version of the files. Select Fork and create a new fork. Keep the default settings and click Create Fork. Once the creation of the fork is complete, then select Code. On the Local tab, be sure to select SSH because we are using SSH keys for our authentication method. Select the copy icon to copy the repository reference. Let's return to SAS Studio. Select Git Repositories and click Clone. Paste the repository URL copied previously from GitHub. Next, click the folder icon. Select a location with write access under the server icon, then select New Folder. Type quick-start-git in the name field, then select the new folder and click OK. Note that the folder for a Git repository must exist on the SAS server and be an empty folder. Under Profile, select the GitHub profile created previously, then click Clone. The Quick Start Git repository opens in a new tab. This is where you can view the staged and unstaged changes in your local repository and push or pull changes to the external Git repository. Let's go to the Explorer. Navigate to the Quick Start Git folder and expand it to view the contents of the cloned repository. Double-click printsample.sas to open the program. We'll modify the first %let statement to change the value of the selection macro variable to random in uppercase. Click Run to execute the program. Confirm a random sample of 20 rows from sashelp.homeequity is generated. Then click Save. Let's go back to the Quick Start Git tab. Select printsample.sas in the Unstaged Changes section to view the modifications to the file. The previous lines of code that were modified are identified with a minus symbol and pink highlighting. The new lines of code are identified with a plus symbol and green highlighting. Select the single down arrow to stage the selected file. The next step is to commit any changes we've made to the local repository, then push those updates to the remote repository. But before committing the modifications made to the printsample.sas program, it's a good practice to first pull any changes that may have happened in the main repository since you cloned it. Select Pull Main and Pull. In the Commit Comment field, type Change Default Report to Random Sample, then click Commit. Let's make one more change in the program. Return to the printsample.sas tab and replace #545b66 in both Title I statements with the word blue. Run the program and confirm the title color is changed. Then save the program. Select the Quick Start Git tab. PrintSample.sas is again listed in the Unstaged Changes list. Select the single down arrow to stage the selected file. This time, I'll type Change Title Color to Blue in the Commit Comment field, then click Commit. Now we're ready to push the changes made in our cloned repository back to the main repository on GitHub. Simply click Push Main to push the committed changes. And verify the last push timestamp is updated. Let's return to the GitHub tab in the browser that displays the forked copy of the SAS Viya Quick Start repository. I'll click Refresh to update the page and confirm the printsample.sas program shows the commit comment and the updated time for the last commit. Select printsample.sas to view the program and confirm the code changes are included. Let's see what happens when a change is made to the code in the GitHub website. In the printsample.sas preview, click Edit. Change random back to first, uppercase, in the first %let statement. Then click Commit Changes. Type Change Default Report to First N Rows in the Commit Message box, then Commit Changes. Now I'll return to SAS Studio and the Quick Start Git tab. In the History tab, you can view the commits made in both SAS Studio and the GitHub website. Notice the first two rows represent the changes we initially made in SAS Studio. Click Pull Main to sync the SAS Studio repository with the remote GitHub repository. You can select the first row in the history list to view the code modifications we made while in GitHub. If you right-click on a row in the history list, you can perform more advanced features, such as resetting the repository based on a previous commit or creating a new branch of the repository. For more information about these features and more, select the Help menu and choose Help Center. Scroll down to find Using Git Integration under Advanced Concepts.